Hi everyone, this is Reverb Audio, and this is some time about comments on music, and I share some of my thoughts and answer some of your questions in a video, which is more fun, at least for me, than just typing away on the keyboard. And first of all, I'd like to start with a curious observation that whenever I post on audio on how stuff works, I generally get thumbs up, and it's rarely ever that I get any thumbs down at all. And when I post about music, there is always thumbs down with it. And this really baffles me, like, what's going on? And I really hope I'm getting the thumbs down for my music videos, because they have improvement to do, or they suck. And because the other option, it's very scary, is that there are audiophiles among us who really don't like to talk about music. And I think that that would be a huge, huge issue, because all this stuff that we do and all these extremes we go about audio, it's really to enjoy the music. And if you are not in for that, then I can't even imagine what can bring someone into audio, or why would they be interested in audio if they don't care about music. And that's what 29 comments about. It's a shame most audiophiles don't talk about actual music. And yep, so that's what I'm afraid of. That's why I'm getting the negative comments, because people don't want to talk about music. But guys, this has to change. We have to get our heads out of the gutter, because when we talk about electronics, about laws of physics, how things work, what do you think about a new deck or whatnot, that's just, those are the tools. But that's really just a secondary aspect to music. And the purpose of all this audio gear is to connect us with music. And I do notice that a lot of audiophiles today are searching for music. And I'm also searching for music, don't get me wrong. I'm not done with the process. But what I have noticed is that many of us, many of you, many on the planet have found really fantastic music, which really touches our soul. And that's what I want to share with you, because I know that every single audiophile is looking for music that touches your soul. And all the stuff we talk about, like detail level, resolution, dynamics, whatnot, it's just dressing on a cake. Those are the things that we think will get us to this music. But those are really secondary considerations. First of all, what we need is to get the right source material, to get the right music. Because if we are listening to canned music, even if it's recorded at the highest fidelity, it's not going to satisfy your curiosity, your soul. It might give you short-term enjoyment, instant gratification, but it's not going to satisfy your lifelong quest for music. And let's have a look at Luz and Frank's comments. They are very experienced audiophiles with very refined systems, and I do consider them, and I also advise you, my dear subscribers and listeners, viewers, to please consider their comments with weight, because they have gone all the way through their audiophile path, and they have found both systems and both music, which makes, I would say, like a complete music lover's path to music. Wow, that sounded redundant. But let's see what Lou wrote, that he heard Vangelis with a duo with John Anderson. And that's, wow, I really wish I would have been there and heard it too, and that was probably phenomenal concert. I was lucky to hear, yes, when they were here in Honolulu playing at the base there. It was a phenomenal concert. And yes, they were with Rick Wakeman. And in one way, I'm really glad that Rick Wakeman stayed as the keyboardist of Yes. But actually, I did not know about this, Lou, that Vangelis was going to replace Rick Wakeman. I think it would have made a heck of an amazing new Yes. But in retrospect, I think I'm pretty glad the way things turned out, because Rick Wakeman is an amazing keyboardist. Is truly phenomenal, and I think for Vangelis, we really needed him to stay on his own and to bring out that unlimited creativity that he had. And his albums with John Anderson, I think those albums, they give us a picture of what would have been the new Yes with Vangelis. And I think of the history of Rick Wakeman, he wanted to play, oh my God, which group was that? I think he entertained the idea of playing with one of the bands in England who were really famous at that time. I forget which band was that, but then I think he decided against, or I'm not sure what happened, but I think that it was this incident when there was consideration of Vangelis. But I didn't know that the group considered Vangelis to be the replacement. It would have been amazing. And Lou also mentions Andreas Vollenweider. He's a Swiss musician, and he has really, really beautiful music. And I have introduced several people, several audiophiles here on the island to him, and it's, I would say, a smash hit amongst audiophiles. And if you want beautiful music, inspirational music, he plays a lot of harp. And he's a harpist, and recorded in a very high quality. Then Andreas Vollenweider is someone I really highly recommend. And Jean-Michel Jarre, he's a French musician. His father was a conductor and a classical musician, and Jean-Michel Jarre also received classical music training. But he went on, look at that. So he went on and played around with electronic music, with computers. And he is one of the fathers of computer-generated music. While in the US, everyone knows about Kraftwerk, that they were one of the first bands to play around with computers. But at the same time, there was Jean-Michel Jarre. And Jean-Michel Jarre is basically, he is a classical music composer using electronic world, the computer, as his orchestra. And his music is absolutely stunning and revolutionary. And if we think of Kraftwerk as the pop level of electronic music, then Jean-Michel Jarre is the classical level of electronic music. And he deserves to be mentioned among the classical composers, because his music is just truly, I would say, of the highest order. And just if you want to get a glimpse of him, listen to his album Oxygen. Oxygen in French. Oh, my cat wants to come in. Let me let him in. Pimpero, come in. Okay, so Oxygen. And let's go what Frank mentions. He said he grew up with Vangelis and was listening at night with headphones. And Frank, that's the exact same way I was introduced to Vangelis. And I was listening through my Sennheiser HD 525. with a Yamaha tape deck, and I was listening to copies from CDs, copies from records, by my friends' CDs and records. And Apocalypse des Animaux is an absolutely beautiful album. It touches your heart, touches your soul. And indeed, if you are a headphone person, then I truly recommend for you to get to know Vangelis, because his music can be really fully appreciated through headphones, because he creates a world for us, and each of his music is completely different. It's almost like being composed by a different composer. I haven't heard two albums from him which sounded remotely similar. And Frank also mentions Aphrodite's Child, which was Vangelis's previous group. And Aphrodite's Child was with Demis Roussos as singer and Vangelis as keyboardist. If you don't know Demis Roussos, he is the most famous singer of Greece. And after they broke up, Demis Roussos continued for a solo career. That was partly the reason for the breakup, because Demis Roussos had contracts already lined up for him as soloist. And Vangelis wanted to go in a different direction, and Demis Roussos really wanted to get more famous. and he thought that's a more fast track. And I think maybe there was some love interest or something else which was created a problem between them. I'm not sure if there was something going on with Irene Papas and Vangelis or Demis Roussos or a love triangle or something. Maybe I'm just going on in a tangent here. But really, when they made their last album together as Aphrodite's Child, Vangelis and Demis Roussos were not talking. So, considering that, their last album, which I'm going to talk about in detail later on, is really a stunner. It's really something that maybe if you want to hear one album in your life, then that would be that album. So Frank says, it's music out of the universe, outer space, and your soul can leave Earth. As his song says, good to see you again. And yes, I think these words really summarize Vangelis. Is that Vangelis really brings the world, brings the universe to us. And if you didn't become an astronaut, then don't worry. You can still go to outer space, just listen to Vangelis. So thank you everyone for tuning in, for listening, for having my thoughts connect to you. Please like, subscribe, watch my videos on music. I really recommend them. And of course, continue watching the videos on audio gear, which you already, all of you, absolutely love. And I thank you for your support. Have an awesome day. Bye-bye.